Blackmagic Design has just announced this, the Hyperdeck Shuttle HD recorder and playback device. A lot of people have been asking for an easy and portable way of bringing in videos to their ATEM Mini setups. Blackmagic have answered your prayers. This is it. And in this video, I'm going to go through the tech specs, talk about some of its capabilities and some of the brand new features jam-packed into this device and why I think it might just be the perfect device to sit alongside your existing ATEM Mini setup. Let's get straight into it. So firstly, let's talk about some of the tech specs and the features that you can find in this. And what is it? It is a Hyperdeck, so that means that you'll be able to both record and play back video using this, despite its tiny size. And if we look at the back here, we've got both an HDMI input and an HDMI output. I'll talk about some of the other ports in a second. If we look at the recording side first, the Hyperdeck Shuttle HD actually records up to 1080p 60 frames per second in a number of different formats. It supports H.264, ProRes, and DNX as well. So that's the recording covered. It will record onto either the SD card with the SD slot at the back of the device, and also at the back of the device is a USB-C port, just like you've got on the ATEM Mini, and you can plug in the same as you do with the ATEM Mini, an external SSD or an external hard drive, and write directly onto that as well. They will work fine for your recordings. But where I think this device gets really interesting is less with the recording and more with the video playback side of things. I think that's where a lot of the ATEM Mini users will really want to pick one of these up as a way of playing videos into your ATEM Mini for live streams and recordings. So for that, you have the HDMI out on the back of the device, as well as also the Ethernet port as well. So you can still connect this to your network and trigger the video playback and selecting which video file off the card and things like that. All the transport controls can be done in the ATEM software control over the network. But where the beauty of this thing really lies is actually the transport controls of the device itself. So on the front, you've got the really large jog wheel, which you can obviously use to navigate between clips and also jog and scrub through the clips themselves. And also you've got these very large transport buttons for the actual sort of skip, the play, the back buttons. And you might also notice at the top of the device itself, there is a menu and a set button, and they're actually recessed into the device. And the reason for that I felt was really cleverly done by the Blackmagic team. It's because obviously there's no LCD screen on the device itself. So to access the menu, it actually appears on the HDMI output just at the bottom left corner of on your screen. And you don't want to accidentally press that button during sort of a live broadcast or when you have that shot live. So they recess those buttons into the device so they're not accidentally triggered, but it means when you're not on that camera or if you've got it plugged into a different display, it's a very easy, simple way of bringing up the menu on screen and then navigating through it. So I thought that was a really clever in the design aspect. Also, just looking at this thing, it's designed, you can very clearly tell, designed with the ATEM Mini in mind. It's the same size as an ATEM Mini Extreme in terms of width, so it'll sit perfectly and nicely. It's built to be sat on a desk next to it. Let's talk about some of the other capabilities of this as well, especially in the video playback side of things. You've got the jog and scroll buttons that allow you to easily navigate between multiple different files that you might have across either the SD card or the SSD that you have plugged into the USB on the back. So it's very easy to actually find different video clips, and you have different speeds that you can do that. The other button I actually liked on here as well is the clip button. And if you enable that, it will actually mean that when the Hyperdeck gets to the end of the clip, it won't just skip straight back on or straight on to the next clip. It will actually hold at the end of the clip. And that's quite important, especially if you're going to be using this in a live broadcast environment. When you get to the end of a video clip, you usually want it to pause. You can cut away onto a live camera, for example. So they've included that feature in there as well. Okay, before I talk about the one new killer feature that is packed into this thing that literally blew my mind when it was announced, let me very quickly talk to you about today's sponsor, QNAP. QNAP creates a wide variety of network-attached storage devices. A NAS, as they're known in short, is a bit like a giant hard drive that stores all of your data in one safe and central location, but it's connected to your network, so multiple people and devices can access and work from it at the same time, whether that be from home, in your office, or remotely from anywhere in the world. They offer a wide range of features like 10 gigabit Ethernet and Thunderbolt 3 connectivity for blisteringly fast file transfers and a whole host of apps too. Like my personal favorite, the Hybrid Backup and Sync app, which will automatically take care of regularly backing up your data either locally or to the cloud. QNAP's NASes are scalable and flexible. You purchase the size of the NAS you need and then populate it with whatever hard drive sizes you require. Take my QNAP for example. I've got 5 of Western Digital's Red Plus 12 terabyte hard drives that give me a total of 60 terabytes worth of storage, plenty for all my video editing projects. I've also fitted 4 Western Digital SSDs to get even faster read and write speeds thanks to SSD caching. I went with the Western Digital drives as they're optimized and specifically designed for use in a NAS enclosure and are tested for 24/7 use. If you want to find out more about my NAS setup and how it has completely changed the way I work, check out my video linked in the description below. There's also a link to QNAP's website below so you can check out their range of fantastic NASes in more detail. Big thanks to QNAP for sponsoring. So let me talk about that one big feature that blew my mind, because this thing has a teleprompter built in. Yes, you heard me correct, a teleprompter. You can actually put onto the SD card, or again, SSD, a .rtf, which is a standard rich text file, or a .txt file, which is a plain text file. And it doesn't matter what formatting or text size you've used in there, you can actually put colors in those text files and that will appear in the Hyperdeck as well. But you basically create your text file, load it as a file onto the Hyperdeck, and then it'll play back as if it was a video. And the fantastic thing about it is you can actually use that jog dial on the Hyperdeck Shuttle HD to control the speed and manually control it as well. And then the killer thing that I heard Grant say, he sort of slipped it in, I didn't pick it up at first in the announcement, is that if you go into the menu of the Hyperdeck Shuttle HD and go into this teleprompter mode, you actually can enable image flip as well. So if you're using this with a teleprompter, for example, you don't need to use a monitor that has the image flip capability because the Hyperdeck can do it for you. It can flip that. And so you really do have a very powerful teleprompter built into this device. And when we come a little bit to talk about the price, how much is jam-packed into this device is really impressive in my opinion. And it really, again, does make it, when you pair this with an ATEM Mini, pair it with an ATEM Mini Extreme alongside the Hyperdeck Shuttle HD, you've not just now got a playback device, but you've also got a teleprompter for your talent. It's starting to get that your ATEM Mini setup that you could pretty much put in a bag, in a suitcase, or in a small flight case is becoming more powerful than the bigger ATEM setup. That all might change next week, by the way, because NAB, big broadcasting show in Las Vegas, it's almost certain that we're going to see some of these features trickle up into the bigger broadcast. I might even do a video about that. Who knows? But for now, we'll concentrate on the Hyperdeck Shuttle HD. But I did want to give this feature a mention because I think it's fantastic. Having a teleprompter in a device that size, it's amazing. And I think it makes total sense because, again, you could just give someone this essential, like, essentially it's like a puck-sized device and say, okay, you run the teleprompter. That is pretty much in a nutshell all of the new features and what is inside this brand new Hyperdeck Shuttle HD device. I'm very, as you, I'm sure you can tell, very excited by it. When I saw it pop up on screen, I was instantly like, yes, because I know how many people have been calling out for a desktop device that can just sit alongside their ATEM Mini and play videos into it. The recording side doesn't excite me that much, but it's nice to have that functionality in there. It still has functionality like the FTP server as well. So if you connect this device to your network, you can also access all of the recordings via the network without having to remove the SSD or having to remove the SD card as well. And also something to mention, that SD card slot does accept SD cards, standard SD cards, but also UHS 1 and UHS 2 cards too. So if you want to use those higher speed cards, that's supported within the Hyperdeck HD Shuttle or the Hyperdeck Shuttle HD as well. So the very last thing to talk about then is of course the price, and it's available for $495 in the US or about £409 in the UK. And I'm going to keep my verdict on this short but sweet. for everything that is packed inside this Hyperdeck Shuttle HD, I think it's worth the money, and I certainly will be getting one. So let me know what you think of this device. Is it missing anything? Are you going to pick one up for your ATEM Mini setup? I would love to know your thoughts. Get them down in the comments below. And of course, as soon as I get one of these, I will do a full review of the physical product and let you know what I think after using it for some time. So make sure you've hit the subscribe button if you want to see that video. I should have more videos coming out in the very near future as well, because I've been working on a few behind the scenes over the last month or so. So lots of new content coming to the channel. So please do hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell. Also, if you found this video useful, it really does help. Hit that like button. I would really appreciate that. And I think that is just about it. We'll have to see what Blackmagic has in store for us in NAB in just under a week's time. I've got a feeling I'm going to be creating quite a few new videos. Thanks for watching.